3,050 athletes, 219 medals awarded, and millions of memories created. I'm Alec Wilkinson in Krasnoyarsk, and a very warm welcome from the Platinum Arena, where the next couple of hours will bring this Winter Universiade to a close by celebrating the young people who have made it so special. From the athletes to the volunteers, everyone has made a huge impact. And we begin with a celebration of sport, of youth, and friendships made.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the closing ceremony of the 29th Winter Universiade 2019 in Krasnoyarsk. Please welcome the Prime Minister of the Russian Federation, Dmitry Medvedev, and the President of the International University Sports Federation, Oleg Matitsyn. Ladies and gentlemen, please stand for the National Anthem of the Russian Federation. Welcome the delegations of the participating countries of the 29th Winter Universiade 2019 in Krasnoyarsk. Austria. Austria.
Six medals for Austria, three golds, three silvers. As we look at Canada, one of the biggest teams here.
Belarus.
Three medals for the Belarusians. Two of them gold, one silver. India. 22 athletes here representing
Belgium.
Them.
Canada.
91 Canadian athletes here. 44 of them took part in the ice hockey. They got a gold, two silvers, and two bronze. And the bronze medal was at the men's hockey. Silver at the women's hockey. No surprises there for the Canadians. China brought 83 athletes. They competed in all sports except for three and come away with four medals.
Czech Republic.
A gold, two silvers and three bronze for the Czechs.
Estonia. Estonia. Finland.
Total of 12 medals for Finland across seven sports, but half of those medals were won in ski orienteering. Great performance from their team.
Francia. France.
France, who ended the Universiade third in the medal table, according to number of medals won. They got 13
Georgia.
In total.
Georgia.
Two of those French medals were gold. Georgia got Germania. Themselves a bronze in
Germany.
The men's single skating. Five medals for Germany, two golds, one silver and two bronze. The Japanese there, five golds, four silvers, four bronze for them, 13 medals in total.
Italy.
Well, Italy host the summer version of the Universiade in July, and they leave Krasnoyarsk with three medals, one
Japonia.
In every colour.
Japan. Kazakhstan.
They had a huge number of athletes representing the country. And they go away with four medals, four silvers, sorry, seven medals, four silver and three bronze for Kazakhstan.
Kyrgyzstan, Kyrgyzstan.
And the Republic of Korea did extremely well and ranked second by total
Latvia.
Number of medals,
Latvia.
14 in total.
Norvegia, Norway.
Eight medals in total for Norway, four of them in the brutally tough sport of ski orienteering.
Russian Federation.
Well, we expected Russia to do very well here at home, but they
Serbia.
Surpassed expectations,
Serbia.
Winning 41 golds, 39 silvers, 32 bronzes, a total of 112 medals. Well, the next country
Slovakia.
With most medals is South
Slovakia.
Korea, and their total is 14. So do the maths, and Russia won 98 medals. More than any other country here. That is extraordinary.
Slovenia! Slovenia!
The last medal won for Russia was in the ice hockey. They beat Slovakia 2-1. There are the Swiss, where the Winter Universiade will go next.
Sweden!
Sweden, two golds, one silver, two bronze, five medals for the Swedes at this Winter Universiade.
Schweizaria, Switzerland.
And Switzerland go away with seven medals from Krasnoyarsk, two golds, two silvers, and three bronzes. So if we rank the countries by both gold medals won and by total medals won.
Turkey.
It's the Russian Federation with a total of 112, 41 gold medals. The Republic of Korea, six gold medals and a total of 14. And Japan with a total of five golds and 13 medals in total. France in the mix there as well with 13 medals, but only 2 golds.
United Kingdom of Great Britain and Northern Ireland.
United Kingdom coming away with a bronze in the men's curling. So some fantastic stories and memories and achievements that have come out of this 29th Winter Universiad.
Ladies and gentlemen, the president of the International University Sports Federation, Oleg Matitsyn.
Dear Mr. Prime Minister of Russia, dear participants and guests, dear people of Krasnoyarsk, dear friends, it gives me mixed feelings to address you again on the day of the closing of the 29th Winter Universiad Krasnoyarsk. We have experienced plenty of emotions over the past days. Thanks to our empathy towards athletes, we share it with them the joy of victory and the disappointment of defeat. And most importantly, we experience sincere admiration for the commitment from all those who contributed to this brightest winter sport festival of the year. And allow me to extend special thanks to a particular group of people without whom the Universiad would have not been possible. I am speaking, of course, about the volunteers.
We'll be right back.
Very soon, the FISU flag will be handed over to the next Winter Universiade host. Dear athletes, please know that we will looking forward to seeing as many of you as possible in Lucerne in 2 years' time, and even at the future Olympic Winter Games. Спасибо, друзья. Спасибо, Красноярск. Спасибо, Россия. And now, with a heavy heart, but with high hopes for the bright future, I declare the 29th Winter Universiade officially closed.
Ladies and gentlemen, please stand for the anthem of the International University Sports Federation.
The anthem, Gaudeamus, Let Us Rejoice.
Gentlemen, please welcome the officials participating in the handover ceremony of the flag of the International University Sports Federation.
Глава города Красноярска Сергей Васильевич Ерёмин.
The mayor of the city of Krasnoyarsk, Сергей Ерёмин.
Передает флаг президенту Международной федерации университетского спорта Олегу Васильевичу Матыцину.
Hands the flag to the president of the International University Sports Federation, Oleg Matytsyn.
So the adventure that began in 2013, when the city was awarded the Universiade, is coming to an end.
30-й Всемирной зимней универсиады 2021 года в Люцерне, Беату Цусли.
Who then entrusted to the mayor of the host city of the 30th Winter Universiade 2021 in Lucerne, Beat Цусли.
Yes, the flag handed from the city of Krasnoyarsk to the Swiss city of Lucerne, who will host the games in January 2021.
Dear Mr. Prime Minister Dmitry Medvedev, dear Mr. President of FISU, Oleg Matytsyn, dear Mr. Mayor Sergey Ерёмин, ladies and gentlemen, dear athletes, what a spectacular meeting the Universiade has been here in wonderful Krasnoyarsk. What a bashing festivity this closing ceremony has been. In 2021, Central Switzerland will host the 30th Winter Universiade. As mayor of the next host city, I am looking forward to greeting hundreds of young athletes and enthusiastic spectators in my hometown, bringing people together and nations together. That's our goal with the Winter Universiade 2021. We will do everything we can to make you feel at home in our well-arranged region. Thank you.
Putting out of the flame. And if you're prone to getting emotional during long goodbyes, now might be a good time to reach for the tissues. The bigger the box, the better. Well, it's been an apt closing ceremony to a Universiade that's been warm and welcoming. The athletes gave us heart-racing moments on the ice, the snow, and in the arenas as well. And many of those athletes came of age here in sporting terms, but in reality as well. And there'll be many names that we first heard here who will go on to even bigger sporting stages.
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for participating in the closing ceremony of the 29th Winter Universiade 2019 in Krasnoyarsk.